as of late, frankly, I've been pretty lazy. I had meant to do a Cosmic Alpha 3 stream, but I kept putting it off, and putting it off, and putting it off, and it just never happened. And now, there's not really any reason to go and do so, because just a few days ago, Cosmic Alpha 4 released the December release of Cosmic. I will be doing a stream of Cosmic Alpha 4, and I have absolutely no doubt that I will uncover some bugs that maybe have been seen before. Very possibly, are just weird things that nobody had bothered to test. Hopefully this time, it's not something like, let's say, you open up the desktop icons and you have a giant memory leak and you use 70 gigabytes of RAM. Let's hope that one doesn't come back in any form of regression. As always, if you want to try out Cosmic for yourself, there is an ISO available right here. You can go and try out the early version of PopOS, or there are packages available on various distros like Fedora, NixOS, Arch Linux, OpenSUSE, and a bunch of others. I tried an Arch Linux. There are no issues whatsoever. There are packages in the main repos, but if you don't just want to use the tagged release, you want to be on the latest Git release, it's in the AUR. Also, if you don't want to go and compile it, it is also available in the chaotic AUR. The first thing to mention is the inclusion of region and language settings. This has been a work in progress for quite a while, the issue being opened on 2022. It is something they knew would have to be done, like, eventually. It didn't make its way into pre-alpha, it didn't make its way into alpha 1, and it's taken a bit to get it into a state where, you know, they're happy with the layout, they're happy with what's being shown, and it actually has the functionality they want. Here you can select your preferred language, as well as preferred date formatting, time, and numbers used by Cosmic. Now, one thing I will say, and I probably will report an issue against this, is this way of displaying a date is the worst possible way of doing so. Is this month day or day month? Because the numbers are the same. And January 1st, day month and month day look exactly the same. But what about January 2nd or March 15th? That's when you start seeing something different. These should be using two separate numbers. So it should at least be January 2nd, so you can tell whether that's month day or day month. Now, being American, it's going to be wrong. It's going to be month day, but it's not clear. Another thing that had to be added eventually is default application settings. This is a more recent issue, being opened in August of 2024. But basically every desktop out there has some sort of interface to do this. You can go and do it through command line changes and things like that, modifying text files, but most people are used to having a singular interface where all of these values exist. It exists on Windows, it exists on KDE, GNOME, and it just makes sense to be there. Now, one thing mentioned here that isn't actually something you're going to be using yet is the Cosmic Media Player. This is going to be their video and music player they are writing for the Cosmic Suite. Currently, it does not have a tagged release, and if we go and look at the issues, there are basic things like this missing right now. So it'll be a thing that exists eventually. Right now, it's just fairly work in progress, and honestly, I might go and give it a try early just to see if it's at all good. For anyone who doesn't know, I am an MPV enjoyer, so I'm probably not going to stop using MPV because it's just better than literally everything else out there. VLC is also good, but VLC is not a media player. It is a media suite. It does a million other things just for playing video. MPV is by far the best. Now, for those of you who are App Store enjoyers, as in not me, because I just go and use Pac-Man, there is an update to the Cosmic Store. While performing updates and app installs, clicking details in the bottom left corner will open a context menu where we can view a list of all in progress and completed tasks. Basically, notifications of the things that you are downloading. Honestly, I am very surprised this didn't already exist. Also, random side note, the link they have here that I guess is supposed to be linking it to the issue that is related to this being worked on, doesn't link to the right issue. So
I don't know who has the ability to go and modify this article, but that's not the right link.
The link is related to a later issue, but it's just not this one. And for the laptop enjoyers, display power management settings, implementation of power management settings for your display are now complete. In power and battery settings, you'll find options for setting how long until the screen times off after remaining idle, as well as independent settings for when your system suspends when plugged in and on battery power. Nothing too crazy, but it's something that needed to be there. Now, this addition is where that earlier issue was supposed to be linked to and is actually linked here as well. So there's duplicate use of the links and the earlier link is just the wrong link. A very, very early accessibility applet. Now, by early, it basically just means you have the ability to enable and disable Orca the screen reader. That is everything that is currently present. The screen reader works in a lot of applications. Obviously, the limitations that already exist with the screen reader on Wayland are still going to be there, but it's going to function on Cosmic, and that's better than nothing, right? Yes, it would be good to have a full accessibility suite, and at some point that is going to be there, but little baby steps, one thing at a time. And next we have just a general good improvement for those who maybe like gaming or just like a smoother experience. Support for variable refresh rate has been added to the Cosmic compositor and display settings. I have a variable refresh rate monitor, but I have one of the ones that is a little bit funky in its hardware implementation, and when I enable it, it leaves me with a flickering screen. Not like horribly flickering, but enough that I notice it. It's kind of like looking at like a plasma screen. This is a problem that certain displays have. So if you notice that problem, it's not necessarily an issue with Cosmic. It doesn't mean it can't be, but just keep that in mind. If there is a widespread issue of things flickering, then there's a problem there to address. But at least for now, it's there for people that have not bad hardware. Now, those are the things that they wanted to add and they wanted to highlight. There were also quite a few bug fixes as well, and some of these, actually quite a number of these, I did report myself, and some of them are really, really dumb. But there is a very common recurring theme. Here is the first of the memory leaks. This one also locks a couple of cores at 100% as well. Here we have someone with 126 gigabytes of memory, all being used by Cosmic. Memory leak after logout slash login with Cosmic settings open. What appeared to have been happening here is if you closed out of Cosmic with the settings open, some of the processes weren't being cleaned up. So when you came back into Cosmic, the daemon reopened, you reopen the settings, you close out again, processes didn't get cleaned up. And you do that enough times and, well, this starts to happen. Here's another fun one. Hotplugging a monitor that has a window open on it, like VK Gears or something like that, causes that window to throttle when the monitor is plugged back in. So it'll be running at something like 1 FPS for some reason. This is one of those things that very easily slips under the radar because, like, how often are you unplugging and plugging a monitor back in? Obviously, it happens, and it's going to happen more often with, like, a laptop or if you're maybe using a projector or something like that. But it's one that's very easy to miss if you're just using a laptop or you're just using a desktop. And here we have the second memory leak. This memory leak was causing certain applets to crash upon clicking them. And here's more of a minor annoyance. When the scroll bar is at the top, dragging applets worked as expected. When the scroll bar is moved downwards and an app is picked up, the applet drop location is displayed offset upwards from the cursor position by the amount scrolled. So if you grab this and start like scrolling with your scroll wheel, it just loses place on where it's supposed to be located, and then
I guess if you're to move up and down, it's going to be like massively offset from its actual location. This is something that you probably notice once as you're setting up your applet and then just like, oh, that was weird, that's annoying, and just never really think about it again. Obviously, it shouldn't be there, and obviously it should be fixed, but it's certainly not like a major issue. Now, I don't use the Cosmic Greeter or a greeter in general. I just log out of my system or I turn it off if I don't want to use it, but they do have a lot of value in the case of a laptop. Now, they especially have value when there isn't a vulnerability where if the greeter or the compositor crashes, you can skip past being logged out. This is a weird bug that most people probably wouldn't see though. I've got my system set up with a KVM that disconnects my monitors from the PC when switching. I normally will lock my system, super escape, before switching, but now when I switch back, the greeter crashes and drops me into a fresh desktop session without making me log in. Now, someone found the same bug through a different method. If you turn on the lock screen, super escape, and then use the standby button, you have to wait until the system is in standby, then wake it up, and you're in an unlocked system. If I do this several times in a row, it leads to 100% usage of my RAM. I didn't realize this was a memory leak again. Jesus Christ. It's all... it's always a memory leak! Just in case you're unaware, and I was as well, being written in Rust does not guarantee that you won't have a memory leak. If you're not cleaning up processes, if you're keeping memory around in weird ways, you are going to leak memory. Just so you know. Just so you're aware. This isn't some like weird magic the Cosmic's done. It's just a bug that all Rust code can have. Now, here we have one of the bugs that I was involved in reporting. So back in August, when I first tried out Cosmic, if you tried to take a vertical screenshot, so you know how it's supposed to, like, pause your screen. This is the paused version of the screen, rotated really weirdly in the center of the screen, as if it thinks it's a horizontal monitor. Also note the, half the display missing. If you took that screenshot, is it in this issue or is it the separate one? There was another one. This one right here, where this is what the actual screenshot looked like. Clearly not working as expected. I was not the only person to see this. This other person also reported the exact same problem. Basically, you couldn't screenshot vertical monitors. Not only couldn't screenshot, you couldn't capture them with a desktop portal either. You couldn't screen record them with OBS either because they're both using the desktop portal. On the topic of bugs that I found, here is the next memory leak. Memory leak with the desktop files applet. So if you remember my last Cosmic stream, when I started the stream and I opened up my system app thingy, my fetch application, or I checked something like BTOP, it said I was using all of my system memory, most of my swap, which equals about, you know, 60 gigabytes of RAM. I found out as well, basically all of my VRAM, because the desktop files applet was not tested at all from what I could tell. And as it reloaded, as it did like refreshes of what icons were actually on the desktop, it must not have been cleaning things up in the background. And the longer you left it open, the more it refreshed, the more RAM you used. The only reason I even realized there was a problem is my mouse started stuttering. I tried to drag Windows. They were like jittering around the screen. Clearly something was wrong. Either my CPU was dying and everything was gonna explode, or there was something wrong with Cosmic. I rebooted the system. I waited for a bit and the exact same problem happened again. I'm very, very happy this problem has been resolved because now desktop icons can actually be used. I know there's a lot of people that just don't care about desktop icons, but if it's going to be a feature, it should probably be a feature that doesn't use 70 gigabytes of RAM. On the note of desktop icons, if you enable or disable them, the toggle now actually works without having to restart Cosmic. Yeah, this is something I noticed. When I noticed this bug was happening, I was like, okay, let's just get rid of the icons. I turn off the icons and the button didn't work. Again, I don't know how this one made its way into the release. I genuinely have no idea. And here is another one from Alpha 1 that I reported. The display settings window just has a bunch of extra padding for literally no reason. There is a scroll bar here. This is all of my monitors. There's not like a fifth monitor, fourth monitor hidden over here. No. No, that's all of them. That was obviously not intentional and now has been fixed. But by far the most important thing, a spelling mistake in the French translation. So now you no longer have to delete the French language package to have Cosmic work correctly. Now, as I said before, I will be doing a Cosmic Alpha 4 stream, and don't you worry. Don't you worry. We're gonna find some more bugs. Maybe by the time this comes out, we've already done that stream. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. Go try out Cosmic. Cosmic's fun. Yes, it's still, like, you know, needs a bit of work. Yeah, sure, sure. We're gonna find more bugs as well. But I think it's getting to be a pretty good state. Also, if you want it to be better, try to find bugs and report them. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and Cosmic's pretty cool.